Okay, sometimes we've got an immovable object, such as a box that we're starting from or the end of a conduit. I'm showing a box. And we've got to jump over a rectangular piece of structure or something that's rectangular in nature. And to do that, we're going to do a four-point saddle. Now, of course, we want our conduit runs to have as less bends as possible in it, but sometimes we're required to, just to follow the suit and make it look good, to jump over stuff. And here we're going to show a four-point saddle. A four-point saddle does require us a little extra thought. We're going to have to know the distance, we're going to know the rise, but also we're going to take care of the pipe shrinkage. So in this example, if we go from the obstruction being this cardboard box example to our immovable start point, we're showing 36 inches. That's a piece of information we need to know. Now we need to know how far up we're going to go. This box or this obstruction is 4.5 inches tall. Now, for us, let's not make it so hard. Let's just call it 5 inches. Right? There's no reason to go half or quarter when we're trying to jump over something. Give it enough room. We want to stay away from it. We don't want to be touching it anyway. So let's call this 5-inch offset. 5-inch four-point saddle, starting at 36 inches. Now, we have a card, and we're going to use, for 5-inch offset, 5-inch four-point saddle, we're going to use 30-degree angles. We always want to use 30-degree angles if we can. For our 30-degree offset, which is what this will start out to be, then we've got a physical dimension we're going to deal with. It tells our multipliers 2. So, we got 5 inches of offset, 2 times 5, our measurement from A to B marking is going to be 10 inches. But we get over here. It says 1/4 inch per inch of raise. That's our pipe shrinkage. So we're going to raise 5 inches. So 5 times 1/4 is 5/4 or 1 1/4 inches. So what that means is we had a 36 inch measurement from here to there. We're going to add the pipe shrinkage of 1 1/4 inches. That means on our straight piece of pipe, we're gonna start at 36 inches, but then we're gonna add pipe shrinkage. It's gonna be 1 1/4 inch more. That's 37 1/4. We'll make that mark all the way around the pipe. That's our mark A. Now, everything about a four-point saddle references from mark A. We already know that our multiplier is 2 for a 30-degree offset, so we're gonna multiply 5 inches of raise times 2, and that gives us 10 inches. So our mark B is gonna be back here at 10 inches away from A. We've got 2 more marks to deal with. Well, the other marks are physical dimensions. How far do we need to keep this raise going? We're gonna measure this obstruction, and it says 23 inches. This obstruction we're trying to jump over is 23 inches total physical length. So from mark A, we're going to come down 23 inches. 23 inches puts us right here. That's going to be our mark C. We're going to move that all, mark that all the way around the pipe. And then mark D, our fourth mark, is just a repeat of an offset. And we're at 30 degrees. We're going 5 inches. 2 times 5 is 10 inches. From mark C to our last mark, mark D, it's 10 inches. So make that mark all the way around. So that we understand, mark A, that had our pipe shrinkage. Mark B was 2 times our rise, 5 inches times 2 is 10 inches away. Mark C, which is from A to C, is the physical dimension we're trying to jump over. And then mark D, which is measured from C, is just, again, 2 times our rise of 5 inches, 2 times 5 equals 10. Now we're gonna put this on a bender. The important part about a bender and a four-point saddle is this obstruction center being the 23 inches, that's what we're trying to jump over. This hook always looks at this obstruction center. On my benders, I actually put little eyeballs and an arrow to show that we're gonna be looking at the obstruction. That's a good way to train younger people that's not familiar with this. Put eyeballs and arrow and write OBST. That means this hook is always looking at the obstruction. We're going to measure our bend this in alphabetical order. And we're gonna keep everything on the arrow. Our first mark was A. And it's right here. We're gonna put it on the arrow. Gonna bring it down, make sure it stays on the arrow. Put it on the ground. Bend it up to 30 degrees. Again, with that, this bender, the handle straight up is 30 degrees. We can look at it that way. Then we can also check it this way. And that looks really close to 30 degrees. Maybe just a little bit more. Really good. Now for mark B, we'll take it overhead because we'll get the big old tail down here. Spin it around, slide it forward. It never comes out of the bender. Put that on the arrow, mark B. Gotta keep pressure on it because there's a lot of weight in the front of it. Put that on the arrow. Look down it. Try to make it straight. And because it's got so much tail, we're gonna try to bend this one completely overhead. Pull down on it until it lines up at the 30 degree mark. Tell you, we can actually spin this one around. Now we've got so much of a bend in it. And complete this on the ground. You notice our handle's almost right up. Check it with our level. Go ahead and pull it just a little bit more. Right there is 30 degrees. Now, let's mark A and mark B. Now remember I told you we're gonna look at our hook and put our handle on the ground. We have our hook spun around because now we're looking at mark C. Mark C goes on the arrow. Again, we're looking at the instruction. Try to keep everything lined up. Look at it this way. Look at it that way. Make sure we're still on the arrow. I'm gonna put my foot in front of it, shin behind it, give it a start. Once I get it a start, it'll kind of hold there. Get it on the ground. It's always best to do it on the ground if you can. Some things we have to do overhead. Use my 30 degree level. Pull it up. Got 30 degrees right on there. It's a little overbent. Just push it back. It's right in the bubble. Good to go. That's mark C. Mark D. Slide it through. Get it on the arrow. Look down it. Try to keep everything straight. Four bends. The more bends you do, it's hard to keep everything straight. It's a line of sight. Once it's pretty close, put some more into it, some bend into it. And once we get it some, we'll actually complete it on the ground. See how much above we are? Now we just kind of kick it. It lays down flat. Once it lays down flat, we know it's right. Now we check it for dog legs. It's not exactly perfect, but I think it'll work. Now, does it fit? Right there is where it should be. Notice this mark A. It's right at the edge. This box, which was staged there, should be exactly 36 inches away. Took care of the pipe shrinkage. And remember, this box is 4.5 inches tall. We went 5 inches, so we got a little bit of space underneath it, and we want that space to separate the metals or the obstruction.